Hi everyone! If you've ever wondered why I do this at the beginning of my videos, it's because I want to make sure that the audio and the video are pretty lined up. So I'm using a crummy app that records videos for me, and it's easy to use. So that's why I use it. But sometimes the audio doesn't always follow as closely with the action. So that's why I do that. It's also cute. But today I just wanted to talk to you. I've been starting to feel under the weather again, and I'm not sure if it's something related to my normal cystic fibrosis infections or if it's something, you know, viral. Could it be the flu? And I started feeling really poorly yesterday, and I thought if it had fully come out by, you know, in the next 12, 24 hours, that I would know if it was the flu or not. But regardless, I'm not feeling great. I have an increased cough and fatigue. I slept for 6 hours yesterday afternoon. Sorry. I'm achy. I'm running a fever, which I normally don't run fevers. With my CF infections, and if I do, they're usually, you know, low, like 99.7 or whatever. They're never over 100, and so it's been kind of jumping around between like 100 point something to 101 point something, which it's different for me. So, you know, it could very well be that I just caught some random cold, and we all know how those can trigger my other CF things into action. So I do see my doctors on Monday. I'm hoping to be able to wait until then and not have to see them beforehand, because I was just on antibiotics. I just finished about a week ago. So I'm on them for 3 weeks, and I was just in the hospital in October. So, sorry. So I'm not really excited about the thought of possibly having to do that again. So I'm doing everything I can. But, and that brings us to the point of this this video. On days like this when I'm feeling kind of crummy, I'm not like completely laid out where I just need to just sleep and not move. But times when I'm like worn out, I'm feverish, I'm achy, I'm just like really feeling whiny. And then I'll look around the house and I see things I have to do. You know, like I finally got the tree down. Yay! But now I still have to put all the gifts away. Woo! No yay. So I still have to put all our presents away, the ones that we haven't started using. And, when you're feeling yucky, the last thing you feel like doing is cooking, even though I love to cook, or cleaning, which if you cook, you have to clean a lot because you make the mess. And so I'm kind of behind on all that. And we had a couple of mishaps that caused me to have to use some of my energy to clean things. Milo, my 17-pound blue Russian cat, likes to knock things off the counter to get our attention so that we'll go into the kitchen and he'll run over to his little feed bowl and meow, wait for me to feed him. And if we ignore him, he just keeps knocking things over. And unfortunately, that's how he broke my Waterford vase. The only Waterford crystal I have that I had received at, as a gift at our wedding. And that's why last year for our 15th wedding anniversary, it's supposed to be the crystal anniversary, my husband had bought me a new Waterford vase and come home early. And that was the day that I ended up going downhill really quickly and being, you know, rushed into, the hospital because my lungs were falling apart. So anyway, so, you know, you feel crappy and you have all this stuff to do and you're just like, you don't feel like taking a shower, or and if you do, you don't want to do your hair. And, you know, what I try to do is I spend a lot of time in what I call comfy clothes. And a lot of people with CF have problems with excessive sweating. Now, if you sweat excessively, and you have something like more up top, let's say, women. You kind of get sweaty everywhere, just as guys probably have issues down there getting a little more sweaty. So I usually wear you know, something like a tank top and big boxer shorts and a hoodie, because, you know, I can take off the hoodie and cool off when I need to, and when I'm feeling cold, I just need to put it on. My legs usually don't get that cold. I think, you know, 12 years of Catholic school uniforms, you know, I don't even care what my legs feel like. They, you know, we couldn't wear pants to school, so we always had just like the uniform skirt and then bare legs. So I tried dressing cute. I tried to match my boxers with, or not necessarily match, but coordinate. You know, coordinate the colors of my boxers with my with my hoodie. Or if, you know, I'm wearing like cute velvet sweatpants, you know, I'll wear, you know, and the matching hoodie, and I'll wear like a cute shirt under it. And, you know, it's like, a lot of time I spend on the couch using a heating pad, which I'm not going to wear jeans to do that because this is not comfortable. So when I'm home, I'm in bumming clothes. But I try to spruce myself up sometimes. And, you know, this morning I just did not want to get up. I didn't want to go take a shower. And I was like, oh my God. But finally I did it, and I made sure I picked out something cute. So I'm wearing these cute little pajamas. I don't know how I can show you. So the top is it's a white thermal top. And the bottoms, I don't know if you can see. The bottoms are, I'm saying Indian style. The bottoms are like a leopard print that coordinates with the top. And my sister got me this for my birthday. And last year she got me one for my birthday too. And they're just cute. They're more fun than just like, you know, sweatpants. So, you know, it puts me in the mood to want to look pretty. And I know in a lot of my videos from the hospital, I talk about my hair. Oh, I did my hair today and I want to look pretty for you. And it just, if you're not religious and you don't believe, if you don't believe in the Bible or, you know, Christianity or any of that, or Judaism for the Old Testament, I don't want you to get offended by this, but basically the story goes that when you're fasting for whatever, this is for, you know, people fast in prayer, people fast, you know, in cultural traditions. There's all sorts of reasons why people fast. It says, don't make your hair look ratty, wear your best clothes, clean yourself up so that people don't look at you and say, oh, you're fasting. Because it shouldn't be on the outside what, you shouldn't have to see your struggle on the outside when you're doing something good on the inside. And there's another, gosh, I'm so terrible. It's been so long since I was in school. And there's another one that says, don't let the left hand see what the right hand is doing. Basically, if you're donating $5 to the Salvation Army bell ringer, don't let, you know, your other hand know. Basically not going out and saying, look at what I did. I'm fasting for this. And I gave money to these people. And, you know, so, you know, I try to think of that as, even though I'm feeling kind of crummy, and yeah, and honestly, nobody expects me to look good, you know, especially considering some of the things that I go through, but when I can do it, it puts me in such a better mood. Like, I just, even if no one's going to see me, you know, but my husband, or if I'm just going to the pharmacy or something, I just, you know, I just want to look cute. So, yeah, I put on a little bit of eye makeup. I found that eye makeup helps me the most because I'm very pale. And sometimes when I put on blush, it's hard to create makeup for the sick pallor kind of color. You know, I've tried the fair colors, but it doesn't have like that grayish blue undertinge of the sick people. So, you know, I don't wear like a ton of blush, but I like to use like just, you know, kind of like a lip stain, and then my eyes, and I do like eyeliner, mascara. I didn't put eyeliner, but, and then these, yeah, I'm showing you these. These are cholesterol deposits, which we don't know why they are, but they believe it's because my liver doesn't, because of my pancreas inhibiting the insulin getting out and the enzymes getting out to digest my food, my liver creates fats and sugars and they dump them into the blood and it causes like triglycerides and high cholesterol, even if you're not eating that way. And so part of the thing about trying to make myself feel better is also covering up a bit of the things, the physical outward signs of me and being sick. Because up until about 8 years ago, 5 years ago, people would look at me and be like, you don't look sick, you know, and even doctors, I'm in the hospital, they're on, oxygen, you don't look sick enough to be here, and I guess it's a compliment, but, I think, the more that I can do to make myself feel good, that's going to translate in everything else that I do. Hi, baby. And so that's why I do that. And I always do my nails. Always, always. I love doing my nails. I do them myself most of the time. A couple times a year, I'll get a manicure just to clean up the cuticles and get a good hand massage and everything. But I prefer doing them myself because I know what color I'm using. I can reapply top coat. I tried the gel manicure last August, and it took until actually just 2 weeks ago for all the damage to go away. So I'm never doing that again. Because gel, they cure it. It solidifies with the help of UV rays, which is bad, obviously. So it's like you're giving yourself skin cancer. Okay. oh, wow, that's long. Okay. So I tried doing little things that make myself feel better, whether that's, wearing cute, loungy clothes. And I don't even think these are pajamas. I know, like, Old Navy has, like, a whole section that's called loungewear. Basically, like, just hangout clothes. so, whether it's that, putting on a little makeup, doing your hair, I straighten my hair. It's normally straight, but it's not normally, like, shiny straight, unless I, do it. But my hairdresser has been awesome. I've been growing out my hair for about 6 years. 6 years, so it's actually now almost halfway down my back. So I try to make myself look cute, and also I have to, going back to being practical, it helps me not sweat because now my neck's not covered by all this hair. And actually, when I had shorter hair, it was more uncomfortable because the hair just sat on the neck and it was too short to pull up. So the ability to pull all my hair up in like 2 seconds and do that crazy thing girls do where they clip it up real fast, it's so much easier. It's like any of you women who have ever like taken ballet and stuff and had recitals, I'm sure some of you had, some of your teachers said you have to grow your hair out for the recitals so it can go up in a bun. And and it's really true because, it's actually a lot easier. So I get to play around with a little bit of makeup and everything. And, it all goes towards, making yourself feel better. So, that kind of pampering, maybe that's not for you. Maybe you would rather go for a run or a massage is nice. I would love to have a massage. I've had probably 5 or 6 in my life, and I like to have like 5 or 6,000 more. But, if you don't have a thing that you can go to that can kind of lift you out of a funk, because, really, nail polish, you can find cute colors for $4 or $5, And, I like to, give my niece the ones that, like I might use only 3 or 4 times. Now she has a huge, now I have another niece. Now they have a huge collection. So find something that literally helps you physically feel better so that, you look in the mirror and you're like, hey, my hair looks cute today. Or, hey, my nails are cute. And it's just, I don't know. I'm girly. So what works for me might not work for you, but it really just, it's about loving yourself regardless of all the junk that's going on in your body. And like I said, this is not saying that, you have to wear makeup, you have to do your hair when you're sick and in the hospital. I'm saying this is what helps me feel a little bit more human, so that I can deal with the crazy emotional things that I'm going through when I'm not well. And now I'm still looking over to the kitchen because I know I have to clean it up. So, procrastination is a good thing to help you get out of that too. Yeah. I just wanted to touch base, and I'll let y'all know if I, have any worsening of symptoms. I do go to the doctor on Monday, and I'm a little nervous, but we'll see what they say. I'm trying not to get stressed out about what I may have to do, which the worst case scenario for me right now would be going on IVs in the hospital. So that's about it. Thank you for listening. I love you guys. And, make sure you visit my blog. It's at www.theraplink.wordpress.com. So that weird word in the middle is therapink. So I'll put the link up there so you can look at it and visit my blog. And, you can look at some of my other videos here on YouTube. I have a whole bunch of new kitty videos if you're into that. So thank you so much. If you're in a place where it's wintry, be safe, stay warm. It's going to be 3 degrees tonight and we have like 8 inches of snow. So you know where I'll be, right in here. Talk to you later, guys. Love you. Bye.